Students, coming to the next topic in the subject, compiler designs for shift reduce parsing. The name itself is saying we have to reduce the parsing by using the shift concept. Shift reduce parsing. Let's enter into the topic. The shift reduce parsing is a process of reducing a string. So it's just a process of reducing a string to the start symbol of a grammar. What's your main aim? Whatever the string you are taken, okay, whatever the equation that is represented in the form of strings, that string has to be reduced to the start symbol of a grammar. So that is the concept of the shift reduce parsing. Once again, let me tell, the shift reduce parsing is a process of reducing a string to the start symbol of a grammar. So it uses a stack to hold the grammar and an input to hold the string. So here we are using two concepts. One is we are using the stack. What's the purpose of using stack? The stack is used to hold the grammar and an input used to hold the string. Okay. And the input used to hold the string and the stack is used to hold the grammar. The final, our process was, a string has to be taken that has to be reduced to the starting symbol. So this is a shift reducing concept. Shift reduce parsing. Shift reduce parsing performs two actions. One is shift and another is reduce. First you need to shift and then you have to reduce. Let's see what the process was with. So at shift action, so while you're performing the shift reduce parsing, the first one is a shift. First action is a shift and second action is a reduce. So at the first action, at shift action, the current symbol in the input string is pushed onto a stack. First, what you have to do, the current symbol, whatever the symbol that is a current input is there, that has a current symbol in the input string is pushed to stack. Okay, now the stack is holding one input string. At each reduction, the symbol will replaced by the non-terminal. Here, this at each reduction, when you try to reduce the string, the symbol will be replaced. Now, this stack holding some symbol. Okay, so that symbol has to be replaced by a non-terminal. So the symbol is the right hand side of the production, and the non-terminal is the left hand side of the production. Okay, so don't be confused. This concept will be understood by taking an example. Okay, so whenever you are asked to write the shift reduce parsing, just write what is the concept of shift reducing and try to solve the problem example. Then automatically you will get the theory part. Okay, so what in each step what you are going to do. So what you are doing in the shift action and what you are doing in the reduction action. Okay, the symbol in the right hand side of production, what it mean? The symbol is the right hand side production and the non-terminal is should be in the left side of the production. Let's see. Let's take, this is a grammar. S tends to S plus 1, S tends to S minus 1, S may be S and S may be the A, not terminal. And the, here this is the input string whatever we are taking. A1 minus A2 plus A3. This is an input string. Now try to solve the problem. So here I have already written the problem. Now the first, the stack contains an empty stack, that is a dollar. Okay, and whatever the stack that we are taking and the final the input has to be reduce it to the start symbol. So this is a start symbol and the final it has to be reduced to the start symbol. So here the start and end with the start symbol. And the input string is A1 minus A2 plus A3. This is an input string. Okay, and you have to be at the right hand side, you have to place the dollar. So let's write me here. Let me write the grammar, whatever the grammar that we are taking. Grammar was S tends to S plus S, S tends to S minus S, S tends to S and S tends to A. So this is our grammar. Now let's see. First, what I said, the left hand side should be shifted. Shift A1. Okay, I shifted A1 to stack. So now it contains minus A2 plus A3. So reduce by S tends to A. So we know that S is nothing but A. So in place of A1, just place S. Okay, So this is now coming to this step. I replaced A1 in the stack content with S. Now shift minus. The minus has to be shifting. S minus, now A2 plus A3 dollar. So next, what you have to shift? You have to shift this, the left parenthesis. Okay. Now, next is always the left hand side should be shift. Next, A2 has to be shift. Okay, now the stack contains dollar S minus A2. But A2 can be replaced with the S according to our grammar. So just replace A2 with S. Okay, you replaced. Then what you have to do? Again, you have to shift plus the left hand side onto the stack. Next, you have to replace shift A3 onto the stack. So again, here the A3. So according to our grammar, S tends to A. So in place of A, just replace A with S. Okay. Now the right parenthesis is there. Shift the right parenthesis. Okay. Now here, according to our formula, S plus S reduce S tends to S plus S. So here S plus S can be replaced with S. Okay. So just replace S plus S as S. So according to our formula, S within the bracket is nothing but S. So replace S. Okay. Reduced by S tends to within the brackets S with S. Okay. The finally S minus S is nothing but S. So just replace dollar S. And finally, in the input string, what you get? Simply dollar. So finally, the string is accepted. So this is a shift reduce parsing. Let me take one more example so that you will be confident of what exactly the shift reducing parsing. Let me take one more example. Here I will use to solve the problem. Please follow the step by step what I am doing here. Consider the grammar. What grammar I am taking? E tends to, let's take 2E2. E tends to 3E3. E tends to 4. This is the grammar I am taking. And what is the input string? The input string is, let's take the numbers 3, 2, 4, 2, 3. Okay, here I am taking the numbers as an input string. Now I want to reduce the string, okay, to the input string dollar. Let me take stack as to hold the input variables, and buffer stack input buffer, and I'm taking parsing action. So whatever the action that it has to do. Okay, so the first thing is, first take the stack with empty dollar, and whatever the input string that is there, that should be stored in the buffer. 2, 3 dollar. So first is shift, the left hand side should be shift. Shift onto the stack. Shift 3. So now the 3 is shifted. Dollar 3. Now input contains 2, 4, 2, 3 dollar. So this time I want to shift 2. Shift 2. Dollar 3, 2, 4, 2, 3 dollar. Now I want to shift 4. Shift 4. Dollar 3, 2, 4. Okay, 3, 2, 4, 2, 3 dollar. So by seeing this, here E tends to 4. So in the place of 4, I can replace 4 with E. So what I'm doing, I'm reducing. Reduce E tends to 4. So in place of 4, I'm just placing dollar 3, 2, E, 2, 3 dollar. So now again I want to shift, because there is no here. So again shift 2. Dollar 3, 2, E, 2, 3 dollar. So here 2, 3, E, 2 is nothing but E according to our grammar. So reduce the string. Reduce E tends to 2, E, 2. So in place of 2, E, 2, just place dollar 3 E and 3 dollar. So now again shift. Shift 3. Okay. So now what you get? $3E. I shifted to 3. $3. So according to our grammar, 3E is nothing but E. So what I have to do? Reduce. E tends to 3E3. So in place of 3E3, I am just placing E. So $E. And finally, the string is accept. So all elements are shifted and it will be reducing to the starting symbol. Okay. So this is how you are going to reduce the string. Okay. This is a shift reduce parsing. Thank you.